Thank you for all taking time out to be here on a beautiful morning. So I really appreciate that. The topic of discussion today is going to be leadership development for the modern employee. This is how 2017 looks like, right? We all have it, all of us have it today. We cannot imagine our lives without this, right? That's the truth. But in 2007, none of this existed. It's not too long ago. Just 10 years back, none of those were even available for us to access. Which means, in just 10 years, we have all changed. None of us could have imagined to live a life without this today, right? Even if we had to go to the hills to become a saint, we would actually take an Uber to do that. That's the reality, right? So which means, that's how the world has changed in a very short span of time. Now, this gets me to the context of what's changed over time, right? This is something I'd like everyone to think upon for a while. Change has never happened this fast before, and change will never be this slow again. It's very powerful, right? And that's the kind of environments all of us are operating in, and that's the kind of employees we cater to in our organizations. Now, I'd like to look at how, as consumers, all of us in this room have changed over the last 30 years. Because I think that's given birth to the newer employees we are speaking about. Let's start with the first trend or scenario one. Way back when we were all kids, 30 years back approximately, right? The way we consumed different aspects of our lives had changed. So let's start with the first one is news. Good old way of reading the Hindu or the Times of India and of Dofan, that's how news was consumed back then. But today it's apps, right? News and shorts and all of that, digital. How did food change? Earlier you have to walk and feed for yourself, that's the max you can do. But today, I recently went to a friend's house last week and he told, hey, can I Swiggy? It's become a verb today, right? That's how food has become. Food also has become digital for us. And careers, earlier it was a good old resume, but today we speak about LinkedIn on a day-to-day basis and our lives are not complete without it as professionals. That's changed too. Networking relationships. So earlier it used to be which engagement, which wedding should I go to find the better half, the guy or the girl. But today it's swipe right and swipe left. It's changed. And all of this has changed over the last 30 years. And that's made us different at the way we consume things as basic as news, food, career and relationships. And the reason for that is because of digital. Let's look at another interesting trend. We all thought we always had 24 hours in a day. But because we could multitask today, we all have 31 hours with us. And the way it's split is something like this. And interestingly, we all spend 7 hours today for learning and working, so which is good, right? Even that's changed. The next one. We all have moved to an experience economy now. Let me tell you what that means. Pretty good example of coffee that I've taken here. Earlier, it used to be coffee, beans is all we used to consume, which was a commodity, right? The way we used to garner it. Then we went to packaged food or packaged coffee, and that used to be one great time. And that is actually the goods. So we moved from commodity to goods. And then we started actually looking at brewed coffees as well. That's the next one. And the last one today we're talking about is Starbucks. And if you realize, Starbucks is actually giving us an experience and not just coffee. The whole trend has shifted, right? And if you want to see how learners have taken it out, or modern employees like us have also evolved the same commodity goods service experience, it looks something like this. BTech and MBAs or a bachelor degree is a norm. Nobody's going to ask you that today because that's how much of penetration it has happened, right? And then has come to what is executive education or MDPs your audience are taking or participants are taking. And we moved over that to services where we're talking about LMS, MOOCs and centralization and all of that. And the last one we're talking about experiences. People say don't teach us, make us experience. Same like the Starbucks. And here it's an important point to let you know that it is not Gen Y or Millennial or Gen Z. I think it's applicable to all of us who have lost patience. All right? Let me now describe and tell you how a modern employee looks like in terms of a persona. So consumerism has led to a different sort of audience, a lot of people. And when it comes to a professional environment, what kind of people are you now seeing is something like this. This is a modern employee. A modern employee is always distracted. A modern employee is always impatient. A modern employee is always overwhelmed. A question to you, do you think it's going to get better in 5 years from now? No, right? It's a very stalking reality, and that's the truth. And this affects all of us, right from recruitment till leadership development to performance management and whatnot. Because your people in your organization are distracted, are overwhelmed, and are impatient. Now, if this is the kind of audience you have, and you need to serve them, or because this is your clients, per se, then how do you go about it? So interestingly, there's a problem statement that I want to describe here. Like I told in the beginning of the session, leadership development is one aspect we've taken, but can be elaborated to the end of the spectrum as well. How to develop leaders out of modern employees with differing needs and priorities across stakeholders. Now, for any initiative that you might want to do in an organization, you're talking about three stakeholders: business, the employees or learners, and that's you, the third one, the fraternity. Let's start with business. Let's see what their asks are, and let me know if there's any different in your organizations. Business wants accelerated leadership pipeline. Now, the key word here is accelerated. The leadership pipeline was always requested for by your business. But today, the rate at which they want, the speed at which they want, is increased tenfold. And that's changed. And they want full alignment with business goals. And they're looking at effective engagement as well. They want to say, as much as we learned, we had fun. It was not a boring, mundane task. And the last, they want to ensure scale and cost effectiveness at the same time. And all of this was not really an ask maybe 10 years, 15 years ago. But it's going to be the norm starting now to the future. Now, looking at the learner who's right at the center, how has their profile changed and what are their asks are? High comfort with technology and mobile. And the second point is very important. They value experience more than instructions. Precisely the way I shouldn't be doing right now. They want to get engaged and they don't want to actually be told what to do, right? And the third, that's you, I think very important here. Pressure to meet business objectives, that's not changed. Manage expectations from both sides, that's not changed. And content and solution explosion, there's something of an interesting point of view. Content is free. It's available everywhere for you to access. So I think as HR folks, I think we should become more like an orchestrator of a musical group than actually creating something of your own. That's changed from then to today. And the last one, the learner in between today asks a lot of data. I don't mind failing. I don't mind not getting promoted. But give me the data on why I did not get promoted. Why was he or she promoted over me? They always want data analytics. And that's the last ask that goes to be coming to all of you. And that's not going to change. So are we in sync with the problem statement today? Have I missed out something or am I way off the mark? Just want a reconfirmation from the audience here. Are we on track? Yeah? This is a reality, right? So there is a point of view or a design philosophy that KNOLSKAPE has, and I'm going to share that with you. So that's a multi-pronged approach. So you saw three stakeholders, and we described the problem statements of all three stakeholders. And now, if that's the problem statement, then how could we potentially address that? And I'm going to do it again through the three stakeholders' view here. But the interesting point is, I'm going to start with the end in mind. What's the outcome to be achieved? And that is, when we're doing a leadership development program, businesses ask us, can you give us greater innovation, or can you give us increased value, or reduced cost, or sustainable growth? So when we start our design engagement with our clients, we start with all this four, and we say if we're able to achieve two of this, I think we have been successful. And that's how we start. So once you know the outcome, this has to be achieved. Now what is the means to achieve it? The number one, we start with business. So interestingly, this is something that's been a crazy ask from a lot of our clients. Interesting, that's a shift we see in GICs as well, from being a back office to actually being an innovator for the parent company in the US or Europe. Can you do it for us? So, which means the ask is always going to be business alignment and nothing more. So whenever we start a leadership development journey, we always start with the business outcome or what the company is into really. And only then the softer aspects come in, which is of the leadership development that we normally do, which is the whole aspects of change management or could be anything of that sort. But the way we approach that is very different. We offer them safe learning environment. Again, they value not instructions, but experience. So the moment you give them a pilot simulator-like experience for them to address a problem, they can do better. And that's what we do with the learners, or the capability as we call it. And the last is the culture. This is something we really can't influence in an organization, but we leave the first two levers to take care of the third lever. So strategy, capability, and culture leads to outcome. So that's the core framework that we have in how we address the issues of our clients. Now, how have we done it? So some proof in terms of doing that. This is a business model canvas, and you can generate this for any of our clients out there. Let me do it like a quiz again here. This is a 9-box canvas where you start filling a value proposition of an organization. Then you fill for the organization to achieve that value, how would they actually use the internal resources and the external resources and achieve a bottom line. Now, interestingly, when we fill this for one of our clients, I'm leaving that out now, but let's assume we're filling this for Apple. Most of us are familiar with that organization, right? Do you know what's the value proposition of Apple? Any takers here? What's the value proposition of Apple here? Sorry? UX, product innovation, no denying that, but it's much more deeper. Any guesses? No Salesforce, yes. But what's the value they're giving to market? For to us as consumers. Experience, good, that's great. Of course, yes. I think I have to give it to the lady in red, she's almost there. It's pride. They actually call it social currency. Interestingly, it's because Apple gives you a social currency to flaunt. You keep the AirPods today, you keep the phone outside. It's a part of you, right? You're okay to flaunt it. And that's why Apple is moving from phones to even water bottles tomorrow. You never know. And you'll still pay $200 for that water bottle because it's Apple. Because you'll have to own it, right? That's the truth. That's what they give it. So like this, for each of your organization, you can actually fill what the real value proposition is. And then you start filling it. So that's what we start doing it. And the next one is we actually create a business simulation on the business model of the particular company. So what I'm seeing currently is something we mirrored for Kotak. And over time, we're able to connect the business simulations behaviors onto the real branch productivity. And guess what? It's proven and it's approved by the business. So clearly, a learning and development or leadership development activity is connected back to bottom line of a company. And for that, we've used this. The second, like safe learning environments, there is a product for leadership where you can virtually manage teams to bring about productivity. There is another product for influencing people without authority. There are 10 to 12 plus products which seamlessly sync in with an organization's safe learning environments for leadership development. And we bring in the whole shift from unconscious incompetence to unconscious competence through a 4-level change, also through the whole framework that I shared with you. And interestingly, people want data. We spoke about data a lot. Imagine a leadership development program is going to give you a lot of data at the end of 3 months or 6 months. That's personalized and org specific. Even that is possible. And an overall journey looks something like this, like you can see. So it's not pretty much only tech or pure play classroom, but more like a blended model that's in front of you that you can see. And last, to connect the dots between hiring someone till the exit, how can something of the sort really fit in using technology assessments all put together? Then this is something like this. Right from assessment to development to engagement, you can tweak it really well to actually make an impact your organization with data. That's the difference. And interestingly, the whole thing about strategy, capability, and culture that I spoke to you about, nothing better than a reinforcement from Satya Nadella himself. So if you haven't read his book called Hit Refresh, I urge you to grab a copy of it. This is something that from his book I've taken it, and it makes complete relevance to this conversation and what we're speaking. You need new concepts with new innovation, and you have to have the new capability and culture to go after those new concepts. Your existing success kind of fights those things, so you have to over-amplify the new concept and culture required for it, and that's the journey. And I think that's what we're all geared up for as we move forward in bringing about massive changes in organization for the new modern learner. So thank you everyone for your time. Hope this was useful.